When you're studying derivatives, one of the popular problems that gives students fits a lot of times is you'll be given a graph of f of x, but not told what it was. You'll just be provided a graph, like this blue graph right here, and then they will ask you to graph the derivative of f without really knowing what f is written out algebraically, just from the properties of the graph. So here's some hints and some things to look for when you're trying to work these problems. The biggest hint is how you get started with the problem. And the hint is look for the maxes and the mins of your function. Because if you think about it, look at this point right here. It's a relative maximum or a local maximum for f. And we would know right here the derivative equals zero. So if right here, if the derivative equals zero, then that would make it a root of the derivative. And so these give you some solid, steady, consistent points to plot for any type of function. So we would put a dot here, and the yellow is going to be f prime, or the graph of f prime. And right here, it would have f prime would have another root. F prime is zero right here as well. So those are going to be your rock solid points that we're going to base the rest of this off of. Right now, to get the rest of the graph to figure out what it's doing in between these points here, before, in the middle, and after these two yellow dots, let's look at the graph here of f. So you notice before this first yellow point, do you see how the graph is increasing? Increasing is going upwards. Now, what does that infer about the derivative? Well, if your graph is increasing, I think that is equivalent to saying that f prime is positive. You have positive slopes, so your original function is increasing. So if your derivative is positive, that means it just needs to be hanging out above the x-axis. It needs to have positive y values. I did not say that the derivative's slope has to be positive, just the derivative's y values themselves has to be positive. So back here, I need to be hanging out up here, not down here, right? Positive slopes. All right, between the yellow dots, I'll switch colors here to green, we see that these slopes for the original function are negative. So we are decreasing, we know, if the second derivative, I'm sorry, the first derivative is less than zero. So you have negative slopes. The function is decreasing. So when I draw the derivative graph, I need to be down here in between these yellow dots, not up here. Right, and then likewise, for the last interval after the second dot, the function is increasing again, which means that the first derivative would be positive again. So putting it all together, how can we stay above the x-axis, come down, touch this yellow dot, go below the x-axis to get negative y values, come back, touch this yellow dot, and then be positive after that? Well, if you put it all together, I think your graph would look something like this. Positive y values, you hit the first derivative equals zero, you hit a root for the first derivative, and then it comes down. But then once you're negative, you're going to have to turn around at some point to get back to this other root, and then after that root, you'll go back up again. So this is the graph of f prime, where this is the graph of f. Right? Now, in hindsight, let's check a few things. Right? Before this yellow dot right here, before this yellow dot, the derivative is positive. And notice it starts off the derivative at a very high slope, but as you move into this local maximum, don't the derivatives get lower and lower and lower and kind of mesh into or converge into zero? Well, sure enough, your slopes do start off high. And then the slopes get lower and lower and lower. Now, what's confusing is I'm not looking at the slopes of f prime, I'm only looking at the y values alone at f prime. Now, one last little thing to convince you that graph that I drew is correct. If you look at the blue graph, I'll write this in blue, this kind of looks like a cubic. If you're familiar with just your basic quadratics and cubics and linear functions, this goes up, down, up. That just looks like a cubic. Now, what would the derivative of a cubic function be? Something that has an x to the third. Probably something with an x squared. Well, look at the orange graph, the graph of the derivative. Doesn't that look like a quadratic? It does. It does. And so that further explains or shows that this really is the graph of f prime. All right, now we're going to finish up with a slightly harder example. We're going to go through this one a little bit quicker. All right, here's the graph of f, but in two colors, I'm going to do one in red and one in yellow. I'm going to try to draw the graphs of f prime and f double prime. Let's do f prime first. So what I know I need to do is start off looking for the maxes and mins. All these places, these three places, the derivative will be zero. So I'm going to go ahead and put those on the x-axis. And those are what you might call the pivot points or the stationary points or what have you. Those are the roots of the derivative. F prime is zero here, here, and here. All right, now before this red dot, the original function is decreasing. So that means the first derivative would be negative. So I need to hang out below the x-axis. Between this red dot and this red dot, the original function is increasing, so the derivative needs to stay above the x-axis. So I'm below the x-axis, then I'm above the x-axis. Now I have to get back to this root, so I'm going to have to turn around at some point. I have to turn around at some point and come back, touch this root. Between this red dot and this red dot, the original function is decreasing, is going down, so my first derivative needs to go below the x-axis, and then somewhere between the red dots, I'm going to have to turn around to get back to this root, which I do. And then after this red dot, let's look at the original again. Now the graph is increasing, so I need to have positive slopes again. All right, so that red right here would be f prime, f prime. All right, last up, we're going to look for the second derivative of f, which, as you guys well know, is the first derivative of the first derivative. So we can just do this process again, just looking at the red graph. So completely ignore the blue graph. We're just going to look at the red graph. The red graph has derivatives of zero here and here. So I'm going to put a dot here and a dot here. And then the red graph before this yellow dot is increasing, so I need to hang out above the x-axis. And then between the yellow dots, the red graph is decreasing, it's going down, so the second derivative needs to be negative. And then you have to come back and touch this other yellow dot. All right, now after this yellow dot, the first derivative is increasing again. So the derivative of that would be positive, in which case on the second derivative graph you'd be increasing again. So we have the original, the first, and the second derivative. Now in closing, I want to highlight something very, very interesting here. I'll do this in green. Look at the roots of this second derivative right here. It changes from concave up. Now the second derivative, it goes from positive to negative right here at this yellow dot, which means the original function changes from concave up to concave down. I'm not saying the second derivative changes from concave up to down. I'm saying the original changes from concave up to down right here. So if you follow this up and look on the blue graph, look at this point right here. What would you call that? You go from concave up, in which case you have a positive second derivative, to after that point is concave down. That means this is a point of inflection, point of inflection. And sure enough, we see that's a place where the second derivative is zero. Now, if you follow this blue graph, it's concave down, and then where does it turn concave up? Well, it looks like right about here. Looks like that's a point of inflection. We'll follow it down. That's a root of the yellow graph. Of the second derivative. So all of these things fit together. Now, what about degrees? Let me color code these degrees. The original looks like probably a degree 4 polynomial. It goes down, up, down, up. And then the first derivative looks like a cubic equation, degree 3, up, down, up. And then how about the yellow graph? It looks like a quadratic of degree 2. So all these things fit together. So it looks like this is correct. So these can be very, very confusing. I would encourage you to practice these a lot. Do lots and lots of examples, because once you get the hang of it, it is easier, but it takes a lot of time just thinking about these things and really trying to wrap your mind about how the original, the first, and the second derivative graphs are all interrelated.